She's New Zealand's sporting superstar. Dame Lisa Carrington is our most successful Olympian, a record haul of 5 gold medals and 15 world championship titles. Now she has the Paris Games in her sights. But who's the woman behind the wins? Fearless and fearful, serious and relaxed, public and private. Tonight we have special access to Lisa Carrington's inner circle. Here's Guy Heveldt with this Sunday exclusive.
These books hold Lisa Carrington's most personal thoughts. Line after line, year after year. Opening these journals means shutting out the noise.
Nothing less than you would expect.
Lisa Carrington, Olympic champion.
Another gold.
It's something to help me focus, to understand my thoughts, my feelings. I'm nervous that I'll struggle to come down off this. I'm scared.
A reminder of where she's been.
Halfway through, I was wrecked.
And who she wants to be.
What am I learning about myself? I want to be more than just a kayaker or an Olympian. I'm a bit more than just the performances.
Up before dawn. Coffee, a flat white. Jotting down her thoughts. It's the same routine every morning.
I try not to get there too early so that it doesn't force everyone to get there early.
This is the Lisa we know, the elite athlete preparing for her 4th Olympics.
Oh, are you afraid?
On the water, she's the poster girl with the infectious laugh. Off the water, she's kept her personal life private until now. The lone Helberg Award in her living room is the only sign of Lisa's success.
Sticky.
No trainers here. It's Sunday, so that means pizza for lunch.
Nice. Oh, look at those bubbles.
This is Lisa's husband, Michael, but she doesn't call him that.
Do you want to make the next one?
And we can't either. He prefers Bucky.
It'd be very weird if she called me Michael.
Does that happen?
I'm never naughty enough.
Colin the Cavoodle. He's just Colin. Lisa and Bucky got together at a party about 15 years ago.
I was probably quite taken by her smile, her laugh and her eyes. Our first date was a coffee in Takapuna. And she left me waiting for about 45 minutes because of trainings.
I guess he knew what he was in for.
Oh, nice.
That reminds me of when we're in Italy in that cool ass pizzeria place.
Up on the hill.
How far along the track did you kind of realise that he was the one?
The one.
Yeah.
I bought the ring probably 6 years before I actually got down on one knee.
Whilst I always knew that we would get married, it was kind of all about when it was the right time.
There were a couple of moments where I thought this would have been perfect if only I bought the ring.
Every moment we were going out, just the two of us, I thought, oh my God, this is it. No, not yet.
Eventually, it was it.
Did you know Bucky was going to propose?
Yes, I did.
Fiona Hastie's known Bucky since they were teenagers.
So I think it's official, I was Bucky's friend first, and that's important.
She was their celebrant in 2022.
To be able to stay focused and connected to something for that long, you need a really good support network. And Bucky's a fundamental part of that. Someone that understands her and understands it, you know, so well. He's such a unique human in that way.
Any friend of Bucky's is a friend of hers.
We ended up flatting together was just after the London Olympics.
Lisa Carrington! Lisa Carrington! Gold medal!
It was her first.
I remember really, really vividly when they came home from London. There was Olympic rings that were, like, wrapped up in electrical tape, the right colours, and they were on the wall as you walked in the front door. And we, as a flat, decided that we would fill their bedroom with gold and black balloons and then shut the door. And they got home at probably 2 a.m. to arguably what we thought was the best thing ever, but probably kind of annoying when all you wanted to do was just go to sleep.
I just remember a bunch of the boys just diving on them, popping them, and yeah, it was fun.
Dame Lisa is now our most successful Olympian.
Does she show off, for want of a better term, the medals? Like, are they...
No. No.
When you get out of bed at 3 a.m. and you're watching her pedal on the other side of the world, of course you recognise that she's this exceptionally talented athlete. But day to day, she's just like you and me, you know?
Fiona lives north of Auckland on her family farm in Kaiwaka. A qualified vet nurse.
Good girl.
Fiona says she bonded with Lisa over their love of dogs and baking.
Creamy cupcakes, that's my first memory of probably quality time with Lisa.
I love food.
Food tastes good.
All right, so what are we picking today?
We're into the feijoas, autumn feijoas.
And are you and Lisa competitive when it comes to cooking?
No, not really. I'm not really the competitive one.
Is she a calm cook? Or has she got a bit of Gordon Ramsay about her?
I would say she's a calm cook, quite focused, but she can definitely go off script.
Mm. That's kind of interesting because she doesn't go off script peddling-wise.
No, I think you're right. I feel like she's got a real talent in terms of taste and what can kind of go together. Lise typically will make this thing called elephant dung. It is like cheesy, spinachy, cream cheesy, oniony goodness.
Yeah, this is a little recipe that my mum gave me. Most people love it because it's just cheese.
Very good.
Yeah. You were going to go double dip, weren't you?
Look, I was thinking about it, yeah.
Lisa says she has been judged for what she eats.
I was eating an ice cream as an 18-year-old, and one of the senior coaches says, a second on the lips, a lifetime on the hips. Like, I still remember it.
Lisa also knows what it's like to be judged for how she looks.
I'm different. I look a bit different. Whether it's like, wow, the gun shows out, or you look bigger than you were last year. Sometimes I can just have the best perspective and go, you know what, I do have muscles, cool. Other days I'm like, oh wow, that really got me in a low moment. So these are a couple dresses that I have had made for me for the Helberg Awards, which has been really awesome.
But being naturally shy, Lisa struggles at times being in the public eye.
Yeah, so this is one that had made strapless, which I still find tricky to wear. There are days when comments made me second guess what I'm wearing. Probably deep down it's just kind of fear of what people think. What's really awesome is being able to have dresses designed that suit my body and how I feel comfortable. So this other one is a really great example because it's long sleeve. You know, I'm still kind of working it out a bit. I guess it's when you wear it, you own it. So yeah, it's probably just a motto for life really. To own what you're doing and own what you're wearing.
Coming up, the nerves.
I remember having a little chuck in behind the stands.
And the pressure.
I didn't feel quite like myself. I was out of kilter.
What's the difference between Greek oregano and any other oregano?
Read the best.
It's not going to go on your Italian pizza, is it? I think with Lisa and I, we have always enjoyed food, cooking. In the latter years, there's been a little bit of gardening, and particularly veggie gardening, because I'm always a fan of, you know, if you're going to grow it, you might as well be able to eat it.
Do you have a worm farm, Theo?
Nah, we've just got compost.
Fiona Hastie's known Lisa Carrington for about 15 years.
Ooh, oopsies.
And officiated at her wedding.
One of the reasons that I decided to become a celebrant was to have a positive impact on people. And it's actually something that Lisa challenged me about many years ago. She sort of was like, well, you know, what's your why? What are you about?
I want to ask you, what is your why?
What is my why? I think it really sits around how I build the mana of my family, my community, my team. And so what's amazing, I guess, about your why is it can encompass more than just being what you do and kind of acknowledge all aspects of your life, especially through the stages of your life.
Exciting.
And that includes 8-year-old Lisa.
There are things that I have learned, particularly around resilience, and I would love to be able to share those lessons with, you know, kids.
You know, some character concepts. What's this?
So good. 8 years old, Lisa.
8 years old.
Lean and sprightly.
Lisa's been working on a children's book about her and Colin, out later this year. Her mum and dad, coach, they're in it too.
Oh my gosh.
But there's one character they weren't expecting.
8-year-old Bucky, okay.
That is so good.
They've used a bit of creative license here. Lisa and her husband Bucky didn't know each other as kids, but he was into water sports.
I chose surf club because it got me out of Sunday school.
Bucky went on to become a world champion himself in surf lifesaving, so he understands Lisa's drive and why some things have had to wait.
Kayaking has been her priority. Every decision we make as a couple has to be made with kayaking in mind. So, yeah, that's had its impact. We both want a family. You know, maybe 20 years ago, thinking about my future, I sort of thought by 40 years old, I'd have a couple of kids and they'd be running around with my mate's kids. So, you know, times has been FOMO, maybe. It was sort of things that you'd think about when you'd come up to the end of an Olympic cycle, right? Probably when I look back in 2016, it was too early in our relationship. Then 2020 deferred to 2021. Then you've got only 3 years till the next Olympic campaign. The way I sometimes think about it is someone could take 40 years to become an expert in their field. For an athlete, they get 10, 15 years. And so then the stakes are just so high. You know, it's really sometimes a now or never.
Gym sessions start with a warm-up. Today, a bit of a laugh. But that's rare. Lisa trains 6 days a week.
I feel the pressure, the expectation, but what I do know is that pressure can bring the best out of me.
Heart rate was actually not too high this week.
Yeah.
It was a bit calmer, which was nice.
On the sidelines for every gold medal win, her coach, Gordon Gordy Walker.
Last week you talked about her start.
Lisa's success is as much about her mental resilience as it is about her physical strength.
There's that hierarchy of needs, and it's like food and water, basically belonging and then self-actualization. Mm-hmm.
But realising her full potential isn't as easy as she makes it look.
She's just like any of the rest of us. You have good days and you have bad days, right?
Knowing what to say or not say is tricky. Certainly over the years, I've probably said the wrong thing.
There's moments before big races, sometimes I'll be just so afraid of not performing. And I'll call him and I'll get really mad at him for no apparent reason. And I'll put the phone down and then I'll pick it back up and go, I'm sorry. You know, like to have that person that can kind of take and understand and just be there no matter what.
Well, our close friends think any different of you. Colin doesn't care. I certainly won't.
He bears the brunt of some of my conversations when I'm absolutely irrational. And picking up the phone to just have someone like Fiona and just being like, hey, how are you going? She might talk about her Fijos, or she'll tell me that she's just fixed a fence. Having people like Fio and Bucky to give me perspective is the best thing.
34-year-old Lisa will be aiming for a first-time gold in the K4 event in Paris.
That's 4.5 minutes, we're right on.
We talk about paddling, but I would say we talk about it at quite a superficial level. Our friendship is beyond that one thing that she does, right? Kind of my responsibility is to remember that she's Lisa.
Doesn't define her.
Doesn't define her. She's still, you know, the girl from Ahopi, Bucky's wife, Colin's mum.
I love coming home to Colin and Bucky.
Lisa is Te Aitanga a Mahaki and Ngāti Porou.
Being Māori and representing Te Ao Māori is important to me. I always have it there, trying to keep it a part of my day as much as I can, or a part of what I do. I think there'll be a time where I'll be able to engage in it a little bit more, but absolutely really important to recognise where I come from.
What does it mean to you to wear the silver fern?
Yeah, from, you know, being a kid and never thinking I'd ever be able to represent New Zealand to, you know, doing it on the biggest stage is really special.
Have you thought about what it's going to be like when you wear it for the last time?
No, I see it as a huge privilege, and you never know, especially in sport. Every time I wear it like it is the last time.
The amount of joy, fulfillment, and all the experiences that I've had with her have been pretty incredible.
She is New Zealand's most successful Olympian.
I've learned that nothing's a sacrifice, it's just a choice. I will be really disappointed if I lose. Absolutely, I will be distraught. But at the end of the day, sport's a game.
A game that Lisa knows how to win.
Man, I'm going to Paris just so motivated, excited, and yeah, it's gonna be a wicked Olympics.
Well, there's fewer than 100 days until the start of the Olympics in July. Lisa and her teammates leave for Europe this coming Saturday, where they'll continue their build-up. Ka nui te mihi I te wahine toa. We're right behind you for another gold medal.